And those who have phones, please put those phones for this few minutes on silent mode. Really speaking, we should be able to put our minds on the silent mode. We can't even put our phones there on silent mode. As if the president of the country is going to call you. Mind which is scattered has to be collected. It becomes potent and powerful instrument when it is single-pointed. That what is achieved or accomplished by the single-pointed mind is unimaginable for a mind which is weak and scattered. Therefore, the practice of meditation is harnessing all the energy which otherwise gets dissipated. Put it together. This mind is an amazing instrument. But at the same time, it can become a monstrous liability. Stillness of the body, steadiness of the body, the steadiness of the breath, and the stability of the thought is the beginning of meditation. If you find that your body is stable, turn your attention towards the breath. And in turning the attention towards the breath, don't allow the body to lose its alertness and posture. Generally, we never pay attention through our breathing, and therefore our breathing happens through lungs which are lazy. Breathe completely in and breathe out completely. Let the breathing take place only through the nostrils and not through the mouth. One step further, inhale to the fullest capacity and exhale to the fullest capacity. That means you are allowing the lungs to expand and collapse, contract as much as it can. And when this happens, you will discover that as if your brain has woken up and it is fresh like a small child. Remember, we have to create a mind which has the capacity to absorb the knowledge, to become an appropriate instrument of knowledge. Mind which will not twist and turn, distort the knowledge. Because distorted knowledge is no longer knowledge, it is an error. Let the mind follow for a few breaths. Every round of inhalation and exhalation can be counted as one. Follow for 5 rounds of inhalation and exhalation. the conclusion of this evening's talk is that the wise man, the knower of Brahman, the Brahmajnani, Tattvajnani, exceeds every form of imagination for whom Sukham is not something distant in dreams, in future. The one for whom Sukham is immediate, whose Sukham is boundless, limitless, and a worldly person, the unwise person, the ignorant, is not able to make himself free from dukkham even for a moment. The difference between the wise and the unwise is blatantly vivid. And therefore, the wise man, Brahmajnani, is the ideal person portrayed by the Upanishad, by the Vedas, for the entire humanity. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnamahat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vaishishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashyakritau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Gururatmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Thank you all.